Hey, what's up? How y'all doing? Big Daddy here, Duke Southern Grill. So today, I'm going to shoot a little quick video on how to make a simple pizza dough. This is your pizza dough that you can use when you're making your pizzas at home. Any kind of pizza, any style. This is the basics. Then from there, you can build it up. Remember, there's all kind of doughs, crusts that you can put, like your sesame seed crust, your garlic crust, stuffed cheese crust. I mean, I've seen Asiago put on side of the crust and bake like that. But this right here, you first need to know how to do this in order to do those other things. So, in this bowl, what do we have? We have 1 cup of hot water. We have a packet of yeast, or it's about 2 teaspoons. And then we have 2 tablespoons of sugar. And that's it. You're going to let that yeast do its thing. Some call it breathing, some call it activating, some call it germinating. You know what? I'm not one of those people you gotta have a label for everything. I'm laid back. Big Daddy's Kitchen is always laid back. If you're not having fun with what you're doing, you're not gonna wanna do it. So the yeast gotta do its thing. So we're letting it do its thing. But since we already did it for about 10, 15 minutes, I'm gonna add a tablespoon of oil. EVOO is fine. We don't have that. You know, you may see a lot of recipes out there that call for it and you don't have it. Don't shy away from it. You can just use whatever. That's about a teaspoon of salt. And this is important. You only want 3 cups of flour. Those who watch my videos, y'all know what I'm doing. I like to stir it in one at a time. We have a stand mixer. It won't be really necessary to do that. I mean, although, even with a stand mixer, some of the flour can actually stick to the whip. So, although a lot of chefs won't show you, you should, in between, you know, mixing that, shut it down periodically, so you can take your spoon or spatula and scrape down the sides and bottom of that bowl. Make sure you're not missing anything, not mixing. So we have one more. And I decided to do this because I have pizza videos. Tonight I'm actually doing a stromboli video. I'm gonna have some calzone videos. And why do basically the same basic dough over and over again, where I can omit that, shorten the video, and just leave a link or refer to y'all checking this out on YouTube. So you just want to stir this up and to start forming the ball, pulling away from the edges, soaking up that moisture, and then I'm going to ball this, get this balled up a little bit more, and then I'm going to show y'all how to knead it. Be easy. Alright, so I've been kneading this off camera for a few minutes. Maybe about 6 or 7 minutes. And this is basically what the kneading process is. You can't see on my counter right now because the flour is actually taking up, the dough ball has actually taken up the flour that I use. You wanna make sure you put a little flour down on your work surface. Cause this will be a little on the sticky side. So you want it like that. Nice stretch on it. That's a good dough. So what I usually do, you don't have to do this. You just throw it into your grease bowl like that if you want to. But I have a little bit of OCD. So I usually ball mine up like so. It's gonna sit like that in my grease bowl. That's why I know what size that is. In about a half hour, 45 minutes, I come back, that should be doubling the size. And then that's it. I mean, I'm gonna stop right here because like I said, I got another video to shoot. Let this proof double in size. Then you can either separate it or leave it. Once you punch it down and reball it, you can put it in a freezer bag, store it that way. Use a vacuum sealed bag. That way you're not gonna get any freezer burn on it. Or put it in your refrigerator. Should last you about a good week or so, okay? Y'all be easy.